Hey guys, it's Julie from Plan to Create, and I'm coming at you from my glamorous new studio, also known as a tiny corner in my bedroom. We have had a year of transition. I don't know if you guys have followed along, but we recently downsized to a condo in Arizona. We had no intention of living here when we purchased it, but we took the plunge and like sold a ton of stuff, got rid of a ton of things, and now we're living in a smaller space, learning to live with less, and we're surviving. It's a miracle, but it's actually kind of fun. It's an adventure for sure, and I'm just gonna keep on sharing through the process. I'm not ready to share my space yet. It is nowhere near where I want it to be. You can see we have like little like nightstands that are just makeshift until we get the actual ones that we've ordered. So everything is kind of on back order, and setting up a new home in the situation where we're at with like supply chain problems has been interesting, but we're working through it. One thing that I have plenty of is planner supplies, and so that's something that I can go ahead and share with you guys. And I have been getting a lot of questions about the pens, markers, inks that I use, so I wanted to do just a small series here of like, here's the things that I kept with me through the process of downsizing, things that I really love, I really reach for and use. I will never share anything that is just like a stretch. I definitely have certain products that I just grab, and those are the ones that I share. And so this first video, I will walk you through the pens that I use. I'm going to walk you through how I refill them with the favorite inks that I love. And then stay tuned, because I'll cover the markers and inks in a future video. So thanks for sticking around so far. Let's get down to the actual subject of this. Okay, so first things first, I love to use the Uni Jetstream pens, and I have purchased packs of theirs where they just come with their normal plastic pen, but I do appreciate a nice looking pen, and so I wanted to show you that I am using these Pen Gems refillable pens using the Uni Jetstream refills. So this pen is in that situation. I have a couple other colors that I have purchased over the years. I like the gold because it goes with my gold rings. So this is what the package looks like. I purchased these through Jet Pens. I have tried to do this on Amazon before, but they're not very consistent with their stocking of these. So I do recommend Jet Pens or something similar to that to go ahead and pick these up. I usually grab a few at a time because I like to have them on stock. And it just so happens that my Pen Gems has run out of ink, so I was going to show you guys how I refill this. So basically, you saw I kind of unscrew this tip, this part slides out, and then this little black part here at the end also screws out. And that's the part. This is it. This is the Uni Jetstream that I recently had. The full, I'll put the description below, but it's SXR-200-05. So you take it out of that little black piece and go ahead and just put in the new one, and I just shove it up there as far as I can without it being super tight. I do want to get it off someday. And then you just take that and you simply screw that in as tightly as you can there and refill. So this particular mechanism just has that twist out, so you twist out to get your pin, you know, out, and then to pull it back in you just simply twist back. Okay, so the other pen I wanted to mention is this one. I've recently purchased it. It's called a Pure Malt, and I found it at Jet Pens. And I'm going to actually screenshot, kind of walk you through the process of how I found this and how I recommend finding pens that look pretty but actually use the Uni Jetstream refill. So you're kind of getting the best of both worlds. Okay, I'm gonna hop over here to Jet Pens and I'm gonna search out the Pure Malt because I already know the name of the pen that I wanna show you guys. You see it right here. You'll notice there are some other options that have like multi-body. That's not what you want. You just want the pen one, at least for this instance. And then right here you can see recommended refills and parts. And that's the beautiful thing. I do select, kind of narrow down the search by ballpoint because I know that the Uni Jetstream is a ballpoint ink and I just wanna make sure I'm getting the right one. And you'll see it had all of those different sizes. I'm picking a 0.5 and a 0.38 because I would like to try that out as well, even thinner tip. And I'm then clicking that compatible products again once I've clicked on the actual refill, and then it shows me all of the pens that are compatible. So you can work either way. You have a refill, you can search which pens are compatible, or vice versa. Click a pen and see which refills. I pointed out that Pure Malt there, but then I'm kind of zipping up here and this gold one catches my eye, so I want to check it out. It's super random. It's a Pilot G2, which seems weird. If you looked at that, you would think I was using a Pilot G2 ink, but the reality is I can have this cool looking
body, but I can still get my Uni Jetstream inks. So it kind of blew my mind at the possibility of this. I thought it was kind of fun. So I'm going to go ahead and add that one just to check it out. I like to have a variety available. The only thing about that, I'm going to go ahead and add in 4 of these refills. They're pretty inexpensive, and I like to just have them on hand versus constantly placing orders for those. I'll probably work myself up to the free shipping level, let's be honest. But then I do one last scan through, and I scan and scan for a second. But ultimately, I'm kind of eyeballing, looking for something with gold, because I know I have gold rings, and I think that that would look nice. Ah, this one catches my eye. Oh, and then there's the price tag, $99. I think I will wait on that one, but it's good to know that it's available. I do like a click pin.
Okay, now I just have a couple of other honorable mentions. This is a Pilot Friction pen that I must have found on Amazon. I wasn't able to locate it on JetPens, but it does have a screw top here, so that has that erasable function like the Pilot Friction, but it's just a really sleek, nice, heavy pen, kind of a rose gold, and it does a click stop and start there. That's been really nice. I will say I'm using the 0.4 and ink point, and it's still a little bit thick and bold for me. So if you love a Pilot Friction and you know that that's your go-to pen, this is a really beautiful option to use on a regular basis. But I'm finding, honestly, I was doing some of my content planning in the Friction because I did like the fact that I could erase it. And I decided, honestly, just to switch over and start using a pencil, which is really random, but I think I'm doing that going forward. I can erase it, and when I'm ready to add something more permanently, I would definitely come back and do it in the Uni Jetstream ink. These are my favorite pencils. It's random to share this, and this is actually just a plastic version. I think there are some nicer ones out there, like a little bit more sturdy bodied, but the biggest feature that I love about these mechanical pencils is the fact that this eraser twists out and it just keeps on going and going. And I always would go through an eraser before I'd ever finish up the lead of a pencil. So this one kind of gives a pencil a little bit more life and stamina for me. I love the fact that it's a white eraser. I'm weird like that. Sometimes I don't like the pink. I don't know why. But anyway, I just thought I would mention that as something that I am going to be putting into my content planning and just something to keep in mind. I think I saw Lindsay Scribbles that she did a video where she was filling out her entire goals in pencil, and she said it was liberating. And that is a good feeling, just to not feel so locked in. Sometimes that can almost keep me from writing things down because I'm so afraid of wanting to switch it later. So a pencil obviously keeps things very fluid, and this is just my favorite pencil. So I hope that that answers some of your questions. That feature of searching, the compatible inks and pens over on JetPens really opens up, you can get just about what any body you want and still get the ink inside. But I'm 100% just in love with this ink in my planner. It is so forgiving, and I can highlight almost immediately. I mean, rarely do I highlight immediately because I'm not that fast, but I just feel like I can write something down in this ink, and I can use my Tombow markers right over it. Not a problem. I can't recall any time I've had any smearing, even on this Tomo River paper that doesn't dry quite as quickly. So if you're just sick of worrying about smearing or, markers smearing your inks, I would highly suggest you check out the Uni Jetstream. It is a ballpoint, which I've mentioned before, so that some people just kind of freak out. I always thought myself that I was more of a gel pen girl, but I still really love these, and I would just use them in any planner. They're just a really go-to favorite of mine. The one last thing that I do want to mention is that these pen gems do slide in and out of my pen loop very nicely. And this guy, he's a little bit thicker, so you can see kind of the size difference there. He would be a lot of work. I don't know, maybe I could get him through, but what I end up just doing is just clipping him there, or I just keep a pen gems in my planner and have him kind of available in my pen pouch or in a cup. So just wanted to mention that for size. All right, you guys, I hope that that answers some of your questions. Like I said, I've been getting a lot of requests about pens, so I thought I would go ahead and just address it, and now I have a place where I can direct all the questions. All right, until next time, you guys take care.